died for our sin. You created us and you redeemed us. You watched us walk away and you came back for us. Lord, you'd rather die than be without us. And Lord, you deserve our worship. You deserve our praise. You deserve our singing. You deserve our attention. And that's what we're here to do, Father. Now, help us by your Spirit. Enable us to follow you, to follow Jesus, and to understand your ways. And Lord, as we sing, fill our hearts with all that you are, all that you've done. And Lord, as we hear from your word, stir us to obey what we hear. And Lord, help us to apply what we hear so that our lives might be changed and that we might have full results.
Ago, when Solomon was led by God and accomplished what his father David was not able to accomplish, which was the construction of the temple in Jerusalem. The third was called Antiochus the Great, but his son was not a lot less powerful than his father, and he got stirred up about the Egyptians because, you know, there's a city in Egypt called Alexandria that's after Alexander the Great. And the Egyptians were wanting to get more than their share of the deal. And so there began to be conflict in this particular area of the world. It's an area of the world that is in conflict to this day. It's been in conflict for 3,000 or more years. Rejected the fact that Jesus is the Messiah. And he says, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. Do you hear the voice of God? A couple of ways you can do it. One is through prayer, that you've got to be quiet and listen to God. And another way is reading the Bible. It's one of the most encouraging verses of the Bible. He doesn't say it once. There's another one I'm going to quote in a minute. It says the same thing, basically, that we're the temple of God, and he lives in you. Christian, a follower of Jesus Christ, you're putting the name of Christ on yourself. So everywhere you and I are, We are his ambassadors. We are his representatives, his agents. We are to be the witness of Christ to everyone around us. So need to keep our thinking in that area. And the third thing is, ask God for forgiveness and healing. 2 Chronicles 6:26 says, when the heavens are shut up and there's no rain because they sinned against you, when they pray toward this place and confess your name and turn from their sin because you afflict them, then hear from heaven and forgive the sins of your servants. Your people Israel, that you may teach them the good way in which they should walk, and send rain on your land which you've given to your people as an inheritance. Boy, do we need today the same kind of rain they needed then. We still need God to bless us with himself, his presence, his power, his protection, and even water. As simple as it is, we need water. So we ask God for forgiveness. And then God knows your heart. You can't say, well, how does God know what I need? Truth is, he knows all of our thoughts. He knows all of our needs. He knows where you are. He knows what you're up to and what you're not up to. He knows you die harder than for me publicly. And what I want to do is to give you an opportunity just to recommit yourself to him. Not an oath. You don't even have to put your name on it. You know what you could do? That little sheet that you have in your bulletin? You could put an X on it if you're a guy. Jennifer, is it a Y for girls? Okay. No, you put a Y if you're a girl.
X for girls.
I got it completely backwards, like usual. So it's X for the girls and Y for the guys. Anyway, put an X on it. I don't want to know who you are. We're not even going to read it. This is between you and the one that died on the cross, Jesus Christ. Got it? We're not going to read it. After 2 weeks, here's what we're going to do. We're going to take them down and we're going to burn them as an offering to God. So what I'm offering today is an opportunity for people who want to commit themselves again to Christ to just make your commitment, it says, with God's help. Nail it on the cross and to just know that that's between you and him, you and him. And then we're going to offer those to him because that's what it says here. It says, fire came down from heaven and consumed the burnt offering and the sacrifice, and that's where I got the idea from the Bible. So after this prayer, God spoke. You know, we speak in prayer, and then God speaks to us through the Word of God, and then he wants us to talk to others about, sometimes Tom and I will say, our 8 to 15, the people in our life who need to hear about Christ. Like the people who were like me when I was a kid and I was under conviction and I was looking for someone to explain to me. Even in a Southern Baptist church where they didn't open the Bible, they just said, well, if you want to be a member of the church, you need to get baptized. I didn't understand all the theology. I just knew that was a wrong answer. And I left and didn't go to church again for 10 years. Sometimes I went to the chaplain in the Army when I was an officer, and I talked to him. He was rude.